Are you looking for a full body, low impact workout that you can do during pregnancy and postpartum that helps heal your diastasis? Well, in this video, we're gonna do just that. Welcome back, ladies. Hi, my name is Tabitha. If you haven't been here before, I'm here to help all you busy moms and ladies juggling jobs, careers, kiddos with no real time to exercise. I'm gonna give you exercise tips, tricks, routines, and even product reviews to help make fitness a part of your life. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hitting that bell to get notified every time I post a new video. But today we are going to do a workout. It's gonna take us about 26 minutes. So grab a pair of dumbbells. I got my mat here. I've got one pair of 10-pound dumbbells, and that's all I'm gonna use for this entire workout. So if you are ready to get started, go get those dumbbells. This workout is going to be great for you pregnant moms out there. We're gonna take it nice, slow, and controlled. Also, if you're a postpartum with diastasis, this is going to be great for you. We're gonna work on a lot of breathing, a lot of slow and controlled movements so that we can heal that diastasis, work on that butt, work on those upper body arms, pull those shoulders back, the whole nine yards. So also, if you're like, oh, I really wanted to do a workout, but I'm not postpartum or pregnant, it's okay. This is totally low impact. So even if you are not in one of those categories and you are new to exercise, you can absolutely join us. So grab those dumbbells. I'm gonna set my timer. We're going to do 1 minute intervals. We're gonna be working one leg and one arm at a time, and then we are going to switch. I have got a list of exercises and we're gonna repeat twice. So as we go through every exercise in this workout, we are going to be breathing. So what I want you to do is put your hands on your ribs. You're gonna rest your pinky down. You're gonna feel kind of the bottom of your rib here. You're gonna rest that pinky down right here on your abdomen. Your thumb is gonna go out to the back of your rib, and you're gonna inhale, and you're gonna feel those ribs expand into your hands. It's also gonna expand your back and your belly. I do not want breathing up here in your shoulders, so we're gonna expand 360 degree breathing, and then we are gonna exhale. Exhale everything from the lower abdomen all the way up. As you exhale, you wanna engage that transverse abdominis, not too strong, but just a nice short little tension on it. Then we will do the movement. This is going to help you get control of your core set, and that will also help to heal your diastasis, give you better posture, and it'll also work on your pelvic floor to help heal that as well. So now let me get my timer started and we will get to it. The first move we're gonna do is a lunge.
One.
So inhale, exhale, step it back, and we're gonna shoulder press up here. One, there we go. Inhale, step it back, and shoulder press, inhale, exhale, step it back, and shoulder press, inhale. Good. Now you'll just hear me breathing. Up, staying all on one side. This is so that we keep balance, control, because we are very weak right now. Back and up. Good. One more time. Back and up. We're gonna go into a curtsy lunge. So same thing, we're gonna inhale. Back to the side, and let's do a curl. Good, and inhale. Curtsy, and curl, all in one leg. Curtsy, and curl, inhale. Curtsy, and curl. Good. Inhale. Curtsy. And curl. Good. Inhale. Curtsy. And curl. Good. Inhale. Curtsy. Curl. Inhale. Curtsy. And curl. Inhale. Curtsy, curl. Good, switching legs for that lunge. So let's kick it back. Oops, I forgot to breathe. And press. Inhale, exhale, back, and press. Good job, inhale, back, and press. Very good, inhale, back, press. Ow. Back, press, back, press, back, press, back, press, turn for curtsy lunge. Let's go, inhale, curtsy, and curl. Inhale, curtsy, and curl. Good, inhale, curtsy, curl. Good, get that rhythm. Inhale, curtsy, focus on that core, that balance. Inhale, curtsy, curl. Good, inhale, curtsy, curl. Good, curtsy, curl. Good, almost there. Inhale, curtsy, curl. Let's get one more. Inhale, curtsy, and curl. Going to RDL, so we're gonna go single leg, step it nice and wide. Inhale, we lift that back leg up. Good, just a small lift, pull it in, and upright row. Inhale, bend, and upright. Good, inhale, bend, and upright. If you only want to upright row one side at a time, that's fine. Inhale, bend, hinging at the hip now, okay? Good. And upright. Good. Up. One more. Hinge. And up. Switch legs. And inhale. Hinge. And up. Very good. Hinge and up. Good job, ladies. Hinge and up, up. Hinge and up. Hinge and up. Good job, ladies. Hinge and up. Good job. Good. I hope you can feel your core working with every breath. I think I missed my upright row there. Hopefully you didn't miss yours. Good. We're going to go into a deep squat. So drop those weights down between your legs. And I want you all the way down right here so that your knees touch your elbows. And we're gonna bring it straight back up. Nice and controlled. Hold that abs in. And drop it down. Nice and low. Stretch. And up. Nice and controlled while you're going up and down. And inhale. Down. Good. And up. If you can't make it all the way that far, do what you can. Nice and low. And up. Inhale. And down. And up. Good. Down. And up. One more time. Down. and up. Good. Turning front again. We're gonna keep a wide squat going 90 degrees, and we're gonna bring our knee up to the center. So squat and lift. So inhale. Squat and lift. Inhale. Lift. Good job, ladies. Good job, nice and controlled. Good job. Squat and lift. Inhale. Squat and lift. We're gonna go other side. Oh, I forgot that. Inhale. Let's lift the other legs. Lift, there you go, inhale. Squat and other knee up, there you go. And inhale, squat, good, and lift. Use those abs, inhale. Squat and lift, inhale. Squat, good. I hope you guys are feeling this. I'm feeling it in my core. So I hope you ladies feel it in your core. Now, a lot of these moves require mind-muscle connection, which you will get there. So stay positive. Good, and lift. We're gonna go to a hip flexor stretch and lift one more. Good. We're gonna step it back. We're gonna go down all the way into a lunging position. Put something under your knee, pause if you need to. Stretching that hip flexor, grab one of those dumbbells, keeping that body nice and straight, and we're gonna just kick it back, nice and controlled. So we're not doing an aggressive stretch here, just a nice little stretch. Hold on to something if you need it. Here, I'm gonna rest my hand on my couch. Good. Allow that hip flexor to stretch. Very good, and kick that tricep back. It's not a rush. We're breathing and relaxing, right? Now, if you need a lighter dumbbell, go ahead and get one. If you don't want to use a dumbbell, you don't have to. You can just use your arm to kick it back, engaging that tricep, allowing that hip flexor to relax and melt away. Let's switch sides. Good, other leg forward. Good, stretch it back. Keeping that chest up and just kick it back. Kick it back, nice and relaxed. Just keep that posture. If you can see, my ribs are right over my pelvis. So I'm not arching my back, I'm not leaning super forward. Just relax and kicking back that tricep. Very good. Good job, ladies. You got this. This hip on me, my right side is a little bit tighter than my left, so I definitely feel the stretch here. Hopefully you guys are feeling this stretch. Mom life. Good. Just relax. Again, you put a pillow under that knee if you need one. 10 more seconds, and then we're gonna go straight back in to that lunge, shoulder press, and up. Grab those dumbbells. Starting with one leg again, let's breathe. Back and press in. Back and press. Good. Back and press. You got your breath down and you can speed it up. Go for it. Good job, ladies. Back and press. Keep that body in alignment. Good. We can do one more, I think. Good, breathe. Back and press. Let's turn for the curtsy. So we're gonna breathe. curtsy and curl. Curtsy, curl, curtsy, curl, good job. Curtsy, curl, good job, ladies. Engage that core, let that diaphragm work. Hope you're getting that expansion in your ribs every time you breathe in. And squeeze those abdominals every time you breathe out. Good job. We got at least one more here. Good. And curl, let's go. One more time. Good. Switch it for the other leg and lunge. Let's go. And shoulder press. Good. Back and press. Back and press. Back. Press. Back and press. Good job. And press, let's go for one more. Back, good job. And press. I think we got another one. We can make it through. Let's just go push it and up. Let's go to that curtsy. Same leg and breathe. Curtsy, good. And curl. And curl, good. Now, if you already have good control of your core, say you're repeating this workout, and you've got that core down, your diastasis is good, feel free to go faster than me. You can absolutely go faster. But this is for those moms who are so brand new. Maybe you're in the first 6 weeks of postpartum. So breathing through is so important. Good. And let's go to the RDL, single leg. Good, breathe. And lift, just a small lift, hinge at the hip, and upright row, and breathe. Lift, good, and up. Very good, ladies. Hinge, and up, and row. Good, hinge. Hinge, lift, upright row, and breathe. Hinge, lift, upright row. Hinge, lift, up. Very good. Hinge, oh, that was a small one for me. And up, let's switch legs. Sometimes you lose your balance. And hinge, and lift. Good. And hinge, good. And up. Hinge, good job, ladies. And up, good. Hinge, lift, up. Hinge, and up. Let's get two more in. Hinge, let's breathe. And up. Let's put these dumbbells down and we're in a deep squat. So in, and drop them low. Good, and up. Good, inhale. Down, all the way. Good, and up. Balancing between 3 points on your foot. So let's feel a heel, the sides of our foot, and the balls, and down. Good. Bending those knees. Sitting with that butt back so you can get into nice deep position, and up. Good. Opening those hips up really. And down. Good. Getting your body used to a squat. This is so good for your pelvic floor. Good, and down. Nice and low, and up. Good job. In. Good, let's squat 90 degree. And center knee raise, good. Inhale. Raise, good. Squat, good. And raise. Squat, and raise, good. Squat, and raise, good. And raise, good. When you squat, make sure those knees track over that second toe, and up. Squat, up, raise, good. Squat, and up, good job. Squat, let's lift the opposite knee now. Good, up, in. Squat, nice and deep, and lift. Good job, ladies. Really use that core to drive that knee up. Good. Squat. And raise, good job. Inhale. Squat. And raise, good job. Squat and raise, good. Squat and raise, good. Squat and raise, good. Squat and raise, good job. We're gonna stat it right here. We're gonna hold that core in. Nice and firm. When let's raise single knee at a time. Hi, honey. Good, just raise it. Single knee, nice and controlled. Stay right there, kiddo. Good, nice and controlled. Let's not try to lose our balance. Keep it right here, lifting with that core. Right after this, we are gonna go into that hip flexor stretch. Good job. Good, nice and controlled. Good, nice and controlled. We'll work out together in a second, okay, honey? My three-year-old wants to work out. Good, nice and controlled. Almost there. We're gonna go into that hip flexor stretch. Good. Very good, almost there. Using that core to lift. Good, keep that core engaged. Very good, ladies. Good. Going down into that hip flexor stretch. Put that knee back. Balance if you need to, chest up. And let's kick that tricep back. Nice and controlled. Good job. Kick it back. Kick it back. Nice and controlled. Feel that hip flexor stretch. Good. This starts looking like a disco in here. I've got a three-year-old on a light switch. Good. Kick that tricep back. Good job, ladies. Good, you should feel a light stretch in that hip flexor. Keep that posture nice and controlled. Don't slouch those shoulders. We are almost there. Again, if you want to drop that weight, you can. Do not need the dumbbell. Whoa. Hold on to something if you think you might lose your balance. Good job. And three, two, let's switch.
Good, other leg forward. And arm back, let's tricep extension. Very good. Good, nice and controlled. You got this. Nice and controlled. Good. Good. Very good, ladies. Kick it back. Keep that elbow nice and close to your body. Good. Don't lean too forward. Don't lean too back. Just nice and relaxed. Good. We're almost there. And then we'll be almost done with this workout. Can you believe it? Nice, good, controlled one. Got it. 10 more seconds. Good. 5, 3, good. And let's grab these dumbbells. So that's it. We're gonna do one more stretch here. We're gonna grab these dumbbells. We're gonna put them right in front of you on the floor. I want you to get into that nice deep squat again, like you see kiddos doing. So you're gonna go nice and deep. You're gonna grab onto your dumbbells. If you have a heavy set of dumbbells, if your dumbbells are not heavy enough, grab onto your couch or table legs. So you're gonna grab on and you're gonna allow it to let your back round out and just pull. My dumbbells aren't hard enough, so let me show you what it looks like on the couch here. So you're gonna allow the weight to just let your body go back and stretch that back and just sit in that deep squat, stretching that back. So you can see my back has got a nice round to it. It's stretching out and just breathe into it and out. Very good. Good. Hope this feels really good for you. And we're gonna go into one more stretch on the floor, just to stretch our lower body again. Okay. Okay, good. You can still see me in the camera. All right, laying down. Actually, we're gonna go one more stretch just like that, but we are gonna put our feet together now. Again, you can grab your weights, but we're gonna just let that back round out in front of us. Now you should feel the stretch in the upper part of your back. So again, grab onto dumbbells or your couch. I really need my couch here, but I'll show you here. So you should be holding on nice and tight right here, allowing those shoulders to just stretch out, allowing the back to stretch out, and inhale into it and exhale. Go. Inhale. Exhale. This can get you a good breath expansion into your ribs. So breathe. Allow those lungs to fill into the spine and the ribs. Very good. Good. So now you know, two good sitting like a baby stretch poses that will be really, really beneficial for you. All right, so ladies, I hope you liked that workout. I hope that was really good for you. If you did like it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. So just so you know that every thumbs up, every comment, every watch really matters for my channel on YouTube. So I'm so appreciative of all of you that do a like and comment and subscribe. Also, this was a workout requested, a full body postpartum workout by one of my subscribers. So if you would like to request a workout or you have something you are looking for and you have not yet found it, go ahead and put it in the comments down below and I will add it to my list. My list is growing, which is fabulous. So I love being able to put content out that you guys actually want and you guys are looking for. So as always, stay positive, work hard, and God bless. Mahalo for joining me. Aloha.